Katie, if you're down here at the 4-H Ag Center,
they're getting all the people checked in. It don't start to 5 o'clock, farm stock. I'm going to try to keep these individual, so, like each class. We'll see if that works or not.
Into the sled now is Team Clad Hill out of Frederick, Mr. Bobby Fogle, running about a 1972 John Deere 4320. Starting out our 12,000 pound class, looks like they're making a few adjustments yet to the sled.
Thank you.
Mr. Luke Gladhill on the Mississippi Mud Pie, the John Deere 4440. All right, Luke had her hooked up to a tree stump earlier this week up there in Johnsville. They were doing a little testing with this thing, so Luke's never ran this thing. Reset the sled, and I think I would take that, but that's just me.
Yeah, because he wouldn't let go. You got that turbo spinning up. I'm going to turbo lift.
Let's see what our track officials have decided. All right, they're going to reset the sled one more time. We don't want them all at the end, or we'll be here all night. Hey, looks like Mr. Sam Poole went back and throwed about 4,000 pounds on this tractor. He was out here at 8,000, now he's weighing 12,000. Or close to it. Seems like these old standard tractors, the heavier you make them, the better they pull. He's out here, I think, with 2 cylinders compared to 6s. But his cylinders are a lot bigger. 1950 John Deere R. We would like to thank many, many of our people coming out here on a beautifully restored International 1256. Her last name is getting ready to change, I think, here August the 20th. And her husband will be running the sled here, or husband-to-be, I should say, will be in the sled later on this evening. Out of the Middletown, Maryland area. Her brother will be out here in the Light Limited class tonight. All he said was, honey, don't break it. Miss Whitney Wansler, Middletown, Maryland. Sled now is Henry Burnett's International 806. Looks like he said, Dad, you can drive tonight. Mr. Jimmy is on it. Right up the road here, welcome for Mr. Jimmy Burnett. Jimmy, 239.70. International 1466. He would cut the narrow from under. Them big old balloon tires didn't help him on this track. Boy, they got to bouncing on him some kind of bad. And he went 263.902. For Travis. Sharp-looking 40-20, Mr. David King. Good enough to put him in that number one spot. Luke went 291.36, 291.36. 281.39 for Class Brother Forearms. Alrighty, another one out of Team Gladhill. John Deere 4320. They got a couple of them here tonight. This one has the Ropps and the Sundard one. Mr. Marshall Gladhill is at the wheel here this evening. Gladhill family's been involved in pulling since the late 60s. Just the setup, pump setups and charger setups for the late Coleman Wheatley. Coleman pulled here many, many years when he lived in Delaware. He came in a few times when he was out to Indiana. It was 25 years ago this week that we lost Coleman to a heart attack coming back from the big Grand National event. Mr. Marshall Gladhill, Frederick, Maryland. Ready, backed up to the sled now is another one out of the Class Brother Farms out of Sykesville. This is Miss Kaylee Tickett. Another lady driver out here trying to show the boys what it is. Ladies chair one, Miss Kaylee Tickett. How to use that power shift. sorry, Miss Kaylee went 238.28. The sled now is Keith Griffith Sr. Junior was out here a little bit ago on the 14. Senior is running a 1968. Hold on there, big boy. Yeah, where's our red fans out there? 353.60. We are running a floating finish line tonight. To shoot back. They brought the big old 6030 John Deere clear up from Anne Arundel County down there in Lothian, Maryland. Mr. Mark Hopkins. Big cubic inch there. We don't have to repair out. 353 is the mark to beat. Shut them down there. They just put fresh blacktop down there the first part of April, so you don't want to dig up CJ's job down there with the blacktop. Seniors out here with the Ford 9000 this time. 241.33 for Dwight Scott Senior Sport. And that's Keith, Dave, and Mark. So far, three of them. They put brand new blacktops in there in the road back in April. They don't want to tear it up. That's why they're shutting them down. And Bobby Tobel gets to come back.
Oh, you imagine when this year they had to come back.
Hoover last Saturday night up in the Buck. He is 80 years old, pulled his old 1066. First time he pulled in.
Came sled out. He was up quicker, more weight.
I don't think it's going to bother him, man.
They're going to at least make 250, but unless they really sled out here. That one, they make 250. I still don't see the other one. The one where he had to keep off people's chests.
Pull-off time, Mr. Bobby Fogel on Team Glad Hill is 43:20. You get one shot at the pull-off. All right, got the chain tight. Green light on the sled. Green flag by Mr. Dusty. There we go. We are underway with a 12,000 pound pull-off. Thank you. run for Bobby. 243.31. 243.31. This is an interesting pull-off. We got two green ones and two red ones. How many green fans we got out there? Let's hear it. How many red fans? That's what I figured. Keith Griffin Sr., Hickersdale, Maryland, with a beautiful 1256 International. David King's back here on the beautiful 4020 John Deere. Davisonville, Maryland. There's our winner for the 12,000 pound, Mr. Mark Hopkins out of Lothian with the 60-30. Second went to David King's 40-20 with 290-11. And third went to Keith Griffith Sr. on the 1256 out of Hagerstown with 279.03. Alrighty, next class B, having them lined up and getting them to the sled, fellas.